Welcome, friends. Welcome back to the kitchen. We are continuing our look at whole muscle dry cured meats. Now, if you checked out last summer, we did a Montreal smoked meat, which is a cured brisket that's then smoked and then steamed. It's like a 2-week process in order to make one of the best sandwiches ever. It's Canada's hipper cousin to pastrami. And I thought, I really like those flavors. And there's a Montreal steak spice that people sprinkle on their steak that is basically the spicing compounds from Montreal smoked meat. So I thought, what if I took this, our Montreal steak spice rub, and we dry cured a piece of beef tenderloin, and let's see if we can get all of those flavors in. So let's start. This is a measured dry cure or an equilibrium cure. So I've got the weight of my piece of tenderloin and I figured out how much salt I need and how much cure number two I need. So I'm gonna put those in. And I have tweaked the recipe a little bit because there's already salt in our Montreal smoked, our Montreal steak spice rub, which is essentially a Montreal smoked meat rub. And I'll put that recipe down below and I'll also link to the video where I make it. It's really dead simple and it tastes amazing. So let's mix these together. And now we rub it all over the tenderloin and we need to use all of this cure mix. And when you rub this into the tenderloin, you want to get it everywhere. And anywhere that there's a little slit or a little seam, you want to make sure that you get the cure right into that seam. Just help it out. Give it as much help as possible. And get it everywhere. Now, I'm going to vacuum seal this for the initial cure. And you want to put this in, and if there's any of the cure or spice mix left on the tray, get that in the bag as well. You want to have it all in there. Okay, so I'm going to write on the package what it is and the date, just so I don't lose track of it in the fridge, which is very easy to do. This will only need 3 or 4 days in the fridge to cure, to be cured. I'm gonna leave it at least a week, just to make sure that I get really good flavor development and see how much of the flavor I can get into the meat. I will take it out of the fridge every day and give it a little bit of a massage, flip it over and stick it back in. So I'll see you back here in about a week, 7 to 10 days, say. It's been about a week and the Montreal steak spice has worked its way into this piece of beef. So I'm gonna unwrap it and I'm not gonna rinse anything off because I'm not trying to remove any salt. And I know that the idea is that you remove the salt, excess salt, and excess spice mixture, and then put more spice on top. I'm just gonna put some more Montreal steak spice onto this piece of meat. Wash my hands first. And sprinkle on as much or as little as you like. I've learned that you have to kind of put more on than you think you have to in order to get the flavor at the end. Now, the next thing I need to do is wrap this into a beef cap, which is this crazy looking thing right here. It's from the intestinal section of a cow. It is closed at one end and it's open at the other. I only need about half of this, so I'm going to cut this in half and I'm going to wrap it. And I've done this a few times now, so instead of watching me struggle to do this, I'm going to cut to a montage of me stuffing this in, covering it with jet net, tying it up with string, weighing it, and writing out the tag. And the label should have what it is. So this is Montreal steak spice. The date. And the weight at the starting point. Down to the dry edger we go. Now I've got this dry ager set up on a cycle that is specifically for dry curing charcuterie, which is different than the cycle for dry aging meat. I've also got the temperature set to 12.5 degrees Celsius and 80% humidity, although it's a little bit different right now because I've been opening and closing the door all day. So I'm gonna hang this in here. I'm gonna make sure that it's not touching anything else. And I'm gonna keep checking on the weight. When it loses 30% of its weight, I'm gonna pull it out. This has been hanging out in dry ager in the basement now for about 3 weeks, and it's lost 35% of its initial starting weight. So I've got a little bit of white mold on the outside, not as much as I had really hoped for. It's dry, it's firm. I need to pull off the jet net and the string that I've got it tied up with, as well as the casing. Butcher twine comes off pretty easily. You just kind of get up under the jet net and it will come off as well. Once you get under the casing, it just peels off as well. Okay, it smells really good. Let's cut it open and see what happens. Okay, let's see. Oh, look at that color, fantastic. And here we go.
Hi friends, hi Glen.
So.
That smells really good.
It's beef tenderloin, and I dry cured it using
chili. Red pepper.
Red pepper. Well, it's our. It's our Montreal steak spice mix.
Okay.
So,
I'm not even waiting.
Montreal steak spice is essentially Montreal smoked meat spice.
I can see I taste the hint of the Montreal smoked meat, like that idea, yeah. But it's not quite the same. Like it's like adjacent.
Mm-hmm. Oh.
It's going to be a great sandwich, though.
It's going to be an excellent sandwich. Okay.
Our charcuterie board is really stepping up for the summer.
So this worked out really well. I'm really kind of happy with this.
Did you just do your happy dance?
I did. Because so much of charcuterie making and salumi making and salami making is all about very narrow definitions of tradition. You don't need to stay in those narrow definitions of tradition. Try something else. Come up with your own thing. This is really good. Thanks for stopping by. See you again soon.